Now, some of you will have already seen sets extensively in other courses. For others, this may be something new. And therefore, we're going to very quickly review a little bit about sets. So what is a set? A set is simply a collection of distinct objects. And the objects are the elements of the set. And we're going to write X is an element of S if X is an element of set S. We often write set by simply identifying all of its objects, all of its elements. And notice that the order in which the elements appear is not important. So a set is an unordered collection. The size of a set S is simply the number of distinct elements. And we sometimes denote that by putting, you know, absolute values around it. If you have two sets S and T, then S is said to be a subset of T if all the elements of S are also elements of T. And that's denoted like that. Or sometimes it's denoted that S is a subset of T, but the S is written on the right. And mathematically, you say that S is a subset of T if and only if X being an element of S implies that X is also an element of T. And the way to visualize that is that here we have the set T, and then the set S is somehow inside it. Now, it's allowed for all elements of T to also be an S. Some books will use the S subset of T to mean that S is a strict subset of T, which means there must be at least one element in T that's not an S, and blah, blah, blah. In our case, S subset of T simply means that S can be all of T, or it can be missing some of the elements in T. Okay, so now that we have discussed sets, what we're going to do next is we're going to discuss operations with sets.